Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. That works even better, doesn't it? Welcome to Bryanston School and the Thursday evening wonderful concert we've had for so many years. This is the orchestral concert, not one, not two, not three, not four, not five, but six orchestras. It's incredible. So we're very lucky. I just want to say, to remind you that Bryanston is in Dorset. Some of you know that, some of you don't. Dorset's a very small county, and it's famous for one thing. It's famous for fossils. Anybody here who's interested in prehistoric life and dinosaurs comes down to Dorset to pick up fossils, and Bryanston has its own special kind of fossils. Very, very, very old people that have been around a long, long time. I'm a Bryanston fossil, confessed, okay? Because we're actually, this evening, saying congratulations for 27 years of Bryanston, but guess what? 18 years before that was the beginning of the London Suzuki Group, when we had our first summer school in Wuornos. Caroline Gowers was there, Elizabeth Waterhouse was there, Sir Claire Santa was there, four people here were there. We had like maybe 9, 10, 11 children possibly. It was just all our children. That's what we did. That's what the summer school was. We went for a summer holiday with our friends. And then it grew and it grew and it went to a place called Dartington, which I'm sure some of you know, which is down in Devon. So for many years, for 18 years, we had what you call Bryanston, we called Dartington. And every now and again, there's something that hasn't changed at all, and one of them is the timetable. I'm so proud of that. The timetable you have that says Bryanston timetable, it's still the same one that I did. Have you got your maths out? 27 years ago is when Christine took over, right? 18 years before that is when I wrote that Bryanston timetable, and it's still there. Anyway, it's my special, incredible pleasure to say thank you to three unbelievable, remarkable people that have put Bryanston on the map beyond belief. I travel all over the world. I travel to many, I can't tell you how many countries this year even, you know, Switzerland, France, Spain, all that sort of stuff, and also places like Singapore and Russia and Peru, and I've been to so many summer schools, and there's absolutely nowhere to beat this one. It is completely extraordinary. The standard is so high, the faculty just gets better and better, so the students get better and better. There's one of my students right in front of me staring at me. And the chamber music gets better and better. And the parents, you just get more and more wonderful. And we are so, so grateful to the phenomenal trio for 27 years who've made this possible. I'm going to start with Nick. Nick has been the administrator for Bryanston for 27 years. He's been the person to whom you go to find out about accommodation, transport, bedrooms, everything to do with admin, paying, backs, checks, money, all that sort of stuff. And Nick and I share something very special. We were born in the same month, so I'm very, very pleased to have that special connection with him. And I'm going to ask special Nick, please come. I'm going to ask somebody who you might not know called Liz Fox, who's going to come here, and she's going to present to Nick some special thank you from London Suzuki Group for working for us for 27 years.
Thank you.
So, Nick's got some flowers, which are really lovely to smell, and they're beautiful, but they won't last long. And he's got something to drink, which will smell also beautiful, and probably also won't last long. And the third thing, I hope, is beautiful and will last a very long time. And the next person I want to thank, of course, is Miriam. Miriam's been an extraordinary behind-the-scenes person. She's the person who's made the chamber music of Bryanston world famous, and I mean world famous. It's absolutely extraordinarily difficult. And one organizer after another, and I know them in the United States, I know them in Australia, I know them in Europe, go, chamber music is just too complicated. Because the different instruments and because who plays with who and the availability is just very, very time consuming. But and it also requires a special kind of knowledge, not only of the music, but of the children. And Miriam has got that beyond. She is absolutely a genius. Genius violin teacher. We've seen so many of her students rise up who are now stewards. Miriam, please. As well as just the chamber music. I mean, she is such an integral part of this team. And the spearhead of the entire Bryanston experience for the last 27 years. Her name is Christine Livingston. She is a living legend. She is one of the finest cello teachers in the UK, in Europe, I would say. And she has an incredible mind. I am in awe of her memory, of her skill, her ability to organize, to see the small details and see the big picture. And that's very rare in a human being, and she has got that. And she's just run this with loads of love and skill beyond. Christine, I'm in awe of what you've done for Bryanston, my darling. concert now. Very, very, very touching, isn't it? And I hope that everybody's heart is full of gratitude. It should be. We should be on our knees with gratitude to be here today. We are extremely lucky. So many people in the world having a bad time at the moment. Just think what a joy it is for us to be here in this, what I might almost call phenomenal summer school. It's so unlike any other I know. Anyway, congratulations to them. And now we're going to go on with the Helen Orchestra.
to play you three pieces. The first one's a traditional folk song, Mulberry Bush, and it's been arranged by Ian Butterworth. The second one is Do You Hear Music from Les Miserables, or as somebody in the orchestra said, Les Miserables. And the final one is from Wallace and Gromit, A Grand Day Out. And those two pieces have also been arranged by Ian Butterworth.
Thank you.
Okay, this is the first of my orchestras. I need a sheet this time because I can't remember it all. My brain is getting older. Okay, so we have three pieces to play for you tonight. We were contemplating just two, but we've decided three. The first one is called Cavalcade by Anita Hewitt-Jones. It's a formal procession or people riding horses, so hopefully you'll get that idea. The second piece is a well-known tune from the Pirates of the Caribbean called the Medallion Calls. And the third one was originally called Spaghetti Blues, but we have renamed it the Blue Wonky Horse. Anyway, we think that's influenced by the Spaghetti Westerns by Ennio Morricone.
We are doing two short pieces for you this evening. The first is by Antonio Lotti, who was a 17th, 18th century Italian composer. And it's a short piece of music for the church called Regina Coeli. And it says, rejoice the heavens and praise the mother of God, or the mother of the son of God, if you like to put that way. And the second piece is by an English composer called Benjamin Cook, who was working in the late 18th century, and it's called Epitaph. Epitaph is a little rhyme or a few words in memory which are usually written on a tombstone, but this epitaph is an epitaph for a dormouse. A dormouse, for non-English people, is a species of mouse, and it's called dormouse because it is notorious for its sleeping activities. It sleeps a lot. And this piece is called Epitaph for a Dormouse, and it says that a dormouse has little to fear when it dies because it will not be sort of presented in judgment before the throne of God. However, princes and other powerful human beings need to think about their lives and when they meet their maker. A dormouse is okay.
Raging on chair in the
we sing our next song, which we're going to sing in parts, I'd like to thank Jerome, our new accompanist this year, very much for that round, which is from Holland, a Dutch round. And he told us and thought we might like it, and we loved it. So thank you very much, Jerome, for doing it. And you may have noticed that we were singing it polytextually, I suppose you say, Dutch and English. We were singing in two languages. It was quite difficult. Okay, not at the same time. We thought it was time to sing in parts now, so we're going to sing you a little song in parts.
You
We have two pieces for you. The first one is called Cantilena. It was actually a request by Miriam, so this is dedicated to her and everybody, but this was specially asked for. And the second one is called Incantations. It's described in the little foreword as an energetic and hard-driving tour de force. So hold on to your seats, folks. It starts with quite a slow, haunting melody and then gradually picks up speed and ends quite fast. Thank you.
You'll be relieved to know that we're going to play three short pieces. The first one is, in fact, two short movements put together by Handel. It's two movements from a concerto grosso. The next piece is a short piece by the Hungarian composer Béla Bartók, and it's An Evening in the Village. The last piece is a piece I wrote quite a few years ago, and a few of these, their predecessors have played this at Bryanston, but I've dug it out of the bottom drawer. It's a version of Camp Town Races. Thank you.
at Dartington with Helen Brunner. My name is Jane Apier. I've spent my professional life as a member of the London Suzuki Group that put on this course, and I was chair of the London Suzuki Group for 10 years. I thought you'd like to see who the London Suzuki Group has chosen for the next team to take us into the next stage after the wonderful work that Christine, Miriam and Nick have done. So I would like to bring them on stage so you can see them. The new Nick is called Philip Waite. He couldn't be a better choice. All his children came through Bryanston. He too was chair of the LSB, so we are in extremely safe hands. This is Philip Waite. Director of Music is Karina McAlpine, whom lots of you know. She's been teaching at Bryanston for a long time and also is one of our London Suzuki Group wonderful teachers. This is Karina. And our new music director is Julian, and we're really looking forward to having her take us into the new phase. Welcome all of you.
Congratulations on lasting this long. We're almost at the end, and we've got three short pieces. The first one is by a modern English composer named Philip Lane, and he wrote three nautical miniatures, they were called, and we're playing the third of them. They're all based on sort of sea shanties, anything associated with the sea, and this one is Portsmouth, a famous tune, Portsmouth. It also includes another very famous tune, which many of you will recognise. He combines the two different tunes. So Portsmouth by Philip Lane. Thank you. We play a very contrasting piece by Norwegian composer Johan Svendsen, who was a contemporary of Grieg. They were great friends, and Svendsen, as well as being a composer, was a very well-known conductor. And this piece is called The Shepherdess. It's rather notable that it's not just in for the different sections of the orchestra, but each section of the orchestra is divided again. So you often have even 9 and 10 parts going on at the same time. But a beautiful piece, I hope you like it.
Thank you.
just before the last piece, I'd like to mention a certain group of people here who do a tremendous work. You've seen tonight the stewards assembling the stage, taking it apart, setting the orchestra out again. And that's just a small part of their job during the week. It happens every day. Every orchestra is different. The Coade Hall concerts, many, many other tasks and jobs that most of us don't know about. The stewards do a tremendous work, and I'd like to thank Lena and all of them for the tremendous job they've done. So, stewards, would you like to come out from the wings? And any stewards here who are helping? Person who hasn't been mentioned tonight is Colette, who does a wonderful job, I think, of all the things that we really don't hear about, but it makes it run so smoothly. A lot of the work before the week to do with the accommodation and all the 101 small tasks that need doing, and with so many hundred people here, there are bound to be problems during the week, which she always sorts out with no fuss whatsoever, and just quietly gets on with the job. So, Colette, wherever you are, thank you very much indeed. And the last piece in tonight's mammoth concert is another Hungarian piece. We had Bartok earlier on, and this is a Hungarian named Ivan Szelenzi. And this is the youngsters' dance. Okay. Thank you.